हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम. लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर नंबर 6. इन दैट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू पार्टीशन एंड यूनिफिकेशन ऑफ जर्मनी. जर्मनी वॉज द मेन कॉज बिहाइंड बोथ द वर्ल्ड वॉर्स. इट फेस ह्यूमिलिएटिंग डिफीट इन द वर्ल्ड वॉर टू. सो जर्मनी दैट डिवाइडेड, ओके. सो ऑल इट्स स्टेट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इकोनॉमिक कोलैप्स completely. There was not a single large party left in the whole Germany that can rule the nation. So in addition to that, there was the fear that Germany can create the problem in the world once again if it is emerged as a military power once again. Therefore, the defeated Germany divided into four administrative segments. The Soviet Red Army in the later phase of the war had captured the eastern part of the Germany, and the eastern Germany would remain in the Soviet Union control. And whereas the it was decided that the America would control the southwestern side of the Germany, and France control the area near the France, Britain control the area of Germany bordering Belgium and Holland. In this way, the Germany divided into four parts. America, France, Britain started thinking about certain alternative arrangement. Meanwhile, the atmosphere of distrust, doubt that started between the Soviet Union and America. America and other Western European countries established Federal Republic of Germany. So this was administered jointly by America, Britain and France. On the other side, Soviet Union also declared East Germany as a Democratic Republic of East Germany. So thus, after the World War, two independent German state came into existence. So Germany divided into two parts, Western Germany and Eastern Germany. Western Germany democratic, that controlled by the America. Eastern Germany controlled by the communist, means Soviet Union. As Germany's three Western segments united and three administrative segments of the Berlin also united. So in the reaction to this, Soviet Union in 1948 declared Berlin blockade. So this resulted into tremendous tension between Soviet Union and Western countries. Later on, a very high and 42 kilometer long wall separating Western Eastern Berlin was constructed. So a wall was constructed that considered as a Berlin Wall. The communist government tried to prevent thousands of the Eastern German citizens from jumping and entering into the free segment, free atmosphere of Western Germany. So people of the Eastern Germany, they jumped and they want to enter in the Eastern Western Germany. Many people lost their lives in doing so. And all about 4 to 4.5 decades, Western Germany made a very astonishing, surprising development. Experts consider this as a German miracle. There was no remarkable changes in economic condition of Eastern Germany. So the Eastern German communist government crush all the hope and desire of the people and political freedom of the people. So till 1990, many important changes took place in world politics. So Cold War that started between the two superpower that ended, and these years witnessed the crack in the otherwise impregnable Soviet Union. Ultimately, Soviet Union that disintegrated, means divided. And as a consequence of it, October 3, 1990, both the Germany united. Eastern Germany and Western Germany united. People broke down the German wall, broke down the which was symbol of the German division. People considered demolition of the Berlin Wall was the end of the Cold War era, celebrated the occasion wholeheartedly. So both the Germany united, Berlin Wall that demolished. So today, United Germany has turned out to be a very strongest economic power in the Europe, and they have made tremendous effort to be a strongest economic nation in the last decade. Today it has become one of the most important and leading nation of the European nation. Now, disintegration of the Soviet Union. Soviet Union Prime Minister Mikhail Gorbachev, liberal means a free, and policy led to, they decided to disintegrate the Soviet Union. So peaceful division of Soviet Union considered to be a most important thing. And Mikhail Gorbachev became the Prime Minister on 11 March 1989. He had a liberal attitude. Russia had progressed tremendously in the field of science and technology. They also had acquired capability to compete with superpower like America. So Gorbachev adopted two policies, one glasnost means openness and perestroika. In this way introduced economic and political changes with a single-handed communist rule. Now in 1990, process of disintegration of Soviet Union started, and toward the end, out of 15 states, 14 states become independent, and disintegration of Soviet Union came to an end. Now students, India's contribution at international level. In India helped many countries in their freedom struggle and independence. India always opposed imperialism, colonialism, evil of racial discrimination. India supported many nations and active in the formation of United Nations and its movements opposing such evils. India always remained active in the formation of United Nations and it's actively involved in activities. India played most important role in sending military to support the United Nations. Then India also sent the troops to countries like Gaza, Cyprus, Congo and Sri Lanka during that conflict. India also helped in maintaining peace. So India also gave importance to the importance of the disarmaments, means not to produce any weapons. Clear? India that also helped in the leadership of the debates world around in making useful suggestion. Clear? So to spend the money in the upliftment of the poor people, other countries, instead of using money in creation nuclear weapons and military, India tried to uplift the poor people. Military has always demanded from India in the United Nations. World peace has permanently remained India's primary concern for its foreign policy. Clear? Now India's relationship with the other countries. So India's relationship with India and United States, that US. There, after having lots of similarity, there was lots of ups and downs in the relation of America and India. United States did not like that India remained aligned, not accepting his side. Clear? Further, they hope that India should join. But India adopted non-aligned policy. That there is another reason for the not good relation between the India and the US, that US policy that favoring Pakistan. They supported Pakistan in the case of the Jammu Kashmir, and Pakistan had joined US-led power and military bloc. So they and India had signed the policy of non-alignment. So America supported Pakistan in the matter of the Jammu and Kashmir. Treaties regarding nuclear weapons have been become one of the most important points of the disagreement between India and United Nations. United Nations continuously forcing India to sign non-nuclear non-proliferation treaty and comprehensive test ban treaty. But India conducted tests in the Pokhran in Rajasthan in 1998. It was taken seriously certain sanctions were imposed against India as US aided financially and technically. But there was a changes in the relation between India and US when terrorist attack happened on the New York World Trade Center on September 11, 2001. The United States is now accepting the fact that India is growing economically very fast. Now both the countries wish that this should be an intimate relation with each other. Okay, Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited America also and addressed the United Nations. American President Barack Obama also visited. The first American president visited in India on our 66th Republic celebration. So nowadays the India's and America's relations are good. Now India and Soviet Union's relation. The Soviet Union has helped India in many matters, therefore establishing big industries. Soviet Union also supported India in the matter of Jammu and Kashmir. And Soviet Union used the veto powers. Student in third chapter used the veto power in the matter of Jammu and Kashmir. So India's relationship with the Soviet Union supported India in the matter of Jammu and Kashmir. Clear? So now India's relation with the neighboring country, India's relation with Pakistan, so you know very well students. So you know the relation between the India and Pakistan in the year 1948, 1965, 1971. So the war that fought between India and Pakistan, the Pakistan was defeated. So they have signed the Takshant and Shimla Treaty, but Pakistan does not follow it with utmost devotion. In 1999, the Kargil war between India and Pakistan took place. Heads of both the countries have expressed eagerness to resolve all the issue peacefully through negotiation. Now, India's and China's relationship. So, started in the year 1954, China display a boundary reasons on the map. It does disturb the relation between India and China. India opposed greatly, and China shows most of the region belonging to India as belonging to them. So, McMahon border shows bordering region between India and China rejected by China and led further discomfort in the relationship. China attack India in 1962 and capture the region, which were displayed in their maps. Capture certain part of India. India sent military troops to in the border, regaining safeguard to the China. China put an end to the war, and in this way, the war ended. Clear? So, relationship between India and China, that was tough earlier also, nowadays also. Now, India have a cooperative friendly relation. India Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited, invited Xi Jinping, the Prime Minister of China, in the to the riverfront Ahmedabad. Now, India's relation with the Bangladesh. Bangladesh got freedom after many struggles. 1971, Bangladesh become independent and sovereign country. As a becoming that, India helped Bangladesh financially also, technically also, and physically also. Clear? It's helped Bangladesh in certain issues. Utilization of water from Ganga, River Ganga, and its proper channelizing has been talked out between the two countries. So both the countries sharing Ganga River water. During flood, during cyclone, during natural calamities, India helped Bangladesh. Clear? Now, India and Bhutan. A very good and cordial relationship between India and Bhutan. Bhutan trust India, okay, in its securities foreign policy. India assured to aid Bhutan in the telecommunication transportation. Prime Minister Nehru visited Bhutan in 1958. And thereafter, Indian President too also visited Bhutan in 1970. India helped Bhutan in becoming the member of United Nations in 1971. Clear? Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited Bhutan in the year 2014. The inter-security related cooperation has been done satisfactorily. Now, India's relationship between Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is situated in the southern part of India. The relation between India and Sri Lanka is very old. Many Tamilians of India have gone to Sri Lanka and settled over there. The citizenship was main issue between India and Sri Lanka. But continue talk between the India and Sri Lanka, the problem solved. The problem of Tamilians and peaceful talk between Tamil organization and Sri Lanka government was a priority of India. Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited the troublesome regions of Tamilians of Jaffna on 13th March 2015. India helped that reconstruction of 27,000 houses of rehabilitation of Tamilians, those who have gone from India to Sri Lanka. Today, India and Sri Lanka has very good relationship. Now, India's relationship with Nepal. The relationship between India and Nepal started in signing the treaty of the year 1950. According to the treaty, both the countries are considered to be sovereign and preserve national regional unity. Nepali students visit India for higher studies. During the rain, it affect the India badly. To stop the floods due to those rivers, started between the two countries. So 2015, 25th April, Nepal faced destructive earthquake. So which caused the death of 8,000 people. India helped the Nepal in this situation. India and Afghanistan. India has very good relationship with Afghanistan. And India has heartily contributed in reconstruction of Afghanistan, in construction, health and education. India helped financially also during the natural calamities. Okay, the construction of the Afghanistan parliament building is being done by India and Myanmar. India has also very good relationship with Myanmar. After India got independence, when the Myanmar got independence in 1948, from that time relationship has been very friendly. After independence, Myanmar has requested financial aid from India, so India helped it. So now, question answers. Explain, write the about the United Nations and its aims. So, student, the page number 39. In that, the four points are given to you that you have to write it down. Explain the meaning of non-alignment, page number 45. You can see the third paragraph, meaning of non-alignment. Consequences of Cold War, page number 39, last paragraph. Disintegration, unification of Germany, page number 41 and 42, that you have to comprehend. Relationship between India and Russia, so page number 43, clear. And military blocks, that on page number 40, that you have to write it down. After World War, conflict, power between power blocks, cause, situation of the conflict, so that you have to write it down, Cold War for that. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru thought on non-alignment, page number 41, you will get the answer. Nuclear non-proliferation treaty, why India did not sign it, so that you can be able to find out in the page number 43, in that the India's relationship between India and the United States. Now short notes, armament, disarmament, page number 40, you can write down armament, disarmament. Cuban crisis, that the end of the Cold War phases, that the Cuban crisis, page number 40, in that second paragraph, Cuban crisis. Disintegration of Soviet Union, page number 42, last paragraph. And Berlin blockade, that unification of Germany, page number 42, in that second paragraph, Berlin blockade. Establish a United Nations is starting point of the new world. So you have to write it down, the all the United Nations charters and aims. Cuban crisis is considered as the beginning of the end of the Cold War. So you have to write it down, the Cuban crisis, short note only. So this MCQ that given tick mark to you, that you have to do, which ideology followed by countries of coming up leadership of Soviet and socialistic, who had promoter of the non-aligned movement, that Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, which policy played important role in international politics, non-aligned policy. United Charter began with the preamble of the constitution and beginning of the Cold War, disintegration of the Germany.